Okay. Now, RA-9275 can differentiate what's discharge and dumping. So what is discharge? It's an act of spilling, pumping, pouring, emitting, emptying, releasing, or dumping into a water body or onto land from which it might flow off drain into said water. However, dumping is unauthorized or illegal disposal into any body of water or land of waste or toxic or hazardous materials. What does it mean? Simply, discharging is allowed by the law as long as you comply with the standard. So for example, for Class C water, such as Laguna Lake, the POD limit is 50 ppm. If the wastewater effluent from your wastewater treatment plant is below 50 or 50, you are allowed to discharge to Class C. Okay? But any contaminant can be dumped, or that is dumped in any body of water, is tantamount to penalty. Okay? However, for discharging also, if you exceed beyond the standard, you will also have what you call discharge fee. Now, RA-9275 shows you also how to calculate for specific contaminants, such as benzene and so on. For the different water quality parameters that we have discussed are also set in your RA-9275, just like your Clean Air Act. So this refers to limitations on quantities, rates, and or concentration, or any combination of water quality parameters. Again, the same law implements EMS, or Environmental Management System. Okay? Now, although RA-9275 is more on surface water, there is also a provision for groundwater. Now, the law have defined what is groundwater vulnerability and the creation of ground vulnerability map. Now, as mentioned during our discussion with water, we leave the groundwater contamination to civil engineering and environmental and sanitary engineering courses. Now, we're only concerned with surface water pollution. Now, one significant terminology in RA-9275 is the word margin. So what's a margin? It's a landward and outer limiting edge adjacent to the border of any water bodies, or a limit beyond or where saturation zone ceases to exist. Now, this margin is normally set right after your mixing depth or mixing zone. So if in air, there's also mixing height or mixing depth. In water, there's also what you call mixing zone. Okay? And normally, you identify also margins if you identify a certain area as an estuary. Let's say it's a fish sanctuary. So if it has to be inhabited by certain fish, or if it has, you have to cultivate some fish of a specific kind, so this is where you apply the word margin, or the term margin. Okay. In our previous discussion, we have identified point source and non-point source. Although this could be applied in any matrices of the environment, most often non-point source and point source pollutants would be referred to water pollutants. So non-point source are those sources which we can no longer identify the source because of its distance from the point of sampling, but on the other hand, if it's a point source, you can easily identify the culprit. Okay. Now, different pollution control technology is also being encouraged by RA 9275. So you just refer to the different wastewater treatment technology that we have discussed. Your RA 9275 has also defined sludge coming from wastewater. So it also emphasizes the need to have sludge to be treated, either using an aerobic or aerobic process using digester. Now, I mentioned to you that EIA, or Environmental Impact Assessment Law, is already being revised, or has been revised, I don't know the status now, that all wastewater treatment plants should incorporate digester for the treatment of the sludge. It's already a requirement. Before, it's an optional treatment, but now, no more. Probably the reason behind this is the increasing phenomenon of eutrophication. Now, for water quality criteria, we're referring to wastewater here. Normally, your RA 9275 is separated from PNSDW. So when water quality criteria is mentioned, it all refers to wastewater quality criteria. You're not supposed to, because it's not sustainable, to have an analysis of the 35 water quality parameters that we discussed in our lecture, but rather, as stipulated in the law, you have to just have minimum wastewater quality parameters. What are these? This would involve salt oxygen, pH, biochemical oxygen demand, and total polyformia organisms. So any effluent should pass this minimum wastewater quality parameters. Now, recall that in Class C, particularly for the BOD standard, we say that the value should be not more than 50 ppm, right? However, there is a provision in RA 9275 that states that effluent standards for industries producing strong waste could have this acceptable values. For example, if the BOD production or generation of a particular industry is between 3,000 to 10,000, industry is allowed to discharge a BOD of 130 ppm. Why do you think so? If you would compute the efficiency of the treatment, it's about 98%. And we all know that based from your thermodynamics, there's no such thing as 100% efficient. So if you have reached already 98% removal of BOD for specific classes C and D from a particular heavy industry, it's already allowable. So from this point of view, from these provisions, you can see the application of sustainability. Much more if the industry would have a higher influent of 10,000 to 30,000, the industry is allowed to discharge a BOD of 200 ppm because that's already 99% removal of the BOD. And for Class SC and SD, the limit is 600 ppm, which is already 97% removal. And for the heaviest industries, you may have a discharge of 300 ppm for Class C and D and 900 ppm for Class SC and SD if the influent is between 30,000 ppm or more. Do you get the point? Okay, so you do not insist that the BOD would be 50. You should not kill yourself that you do not reach 50 ppm, especially if you work in a heavy industry. What kind of heavy industry are we referring? Distilleries. What else? Distilleries would have fermentation of alcohol, so it would yield high food depending on the type of food being produced. So it all depends on your influence. So that's the reason why in recording, in your self-monitoring report, you must have a wastewater quality analysis of influent vis-a-vis the wastewater effluent quality for the verification from the department.